Welcome friends to Literature Mantra. Today's topic of discussion is Derek Walcott's poem, A Far Cry from Africa. Before moving on, I would like to announce that there is a flat discount of 70% on all our NET courses for English literature. So please check it out. In case you have doubts in any topic related to English literature, you can follow and contact us on social media. We will try to reply as soon as possible. Now moving on to the poem. What is the subject or the main idea? Well, the poem describes the immediate aftermath of the Mau Mau rebellion. The poet persona expresses his own dilemma as to whose side he should take. Now what is the context of the poem? The poet persona tries to question the attempts to club the Mau Mau with the Spanish Civil War. Mau Mau took place in the 1950s, while the Spanish Civil War took place in the 1930s, precisely between 1936 to 1939. Walcott himself was half of Afro-Caribbean descent and half white European descent. Therefore, it becomes a bit difficult for him to take sides or support any particular side. i.e. should he support the Mau Mau rebels or the British colonizers. The images used in the poem. The first image is of the Kikuyu community. Kikuyu community formed the backbone of the Mau Mau rebellion. Then we have a reference where it says blood streams of the veld, corpses are scattered through a paradise. Then again there is a reference where it says beast teeming plains. Now, veld here refers to the landscape of the area. Basically, it is a savanna type of landscape found in many places in Africa, such as South Africa, Kenya, and so on. And then where it says beast teeming plains, it perhaps refers to the wilderness of Africa. Now then again we have a reference where it says violence of beast on beast is read as natural law, but upright man seeks his divinity by inflicting pain. Now this comparison with the animal world where violence and rule of force are supreme is used to point out a similarity. The similarity is that though the human world should be governed with compassion, what seems to take place is its exact opposite. Here, upright man seeks his divinity by inflicting pain. And then there is another line where it says, the gorilla wrestles with the Superman. Now, gorilla here refers to the African communities, and the Superman refers to the British colonizers. This line is ironic because the so-called Superman does not have any of the qualities of a Superman. They just have superior brute strength. Now the dilemma of the poet persona. As already pointed out, the dilemma of the poet arises due to his mixed ancestry. And here we have a direct reference where he says, I who am poisoned with the blood of both, where shall I turn? Divided to the vein. Now, though he expresses his inability to take sides, in the last stanza, he also says, how can I face such slaughter and be cool? How can I turn from Africa and live? Now, the slaughter here refers to the brutality inflicted on the various African communities during the suppression of the Mau Mau rebellion. So, the poet persona finds it difficult to stay cool in the face of such brutality. Now, important points for answer writing. While writing answers, in addition to the things already mentioned, you should also make references to the Mau Mau, reference to the Spanish Civil War, and also a critique of the civilizing mission of Europe, especially when the poet says, upright man seeks his divinity by inflicting pain. And in particular, you should point out the differences between the Mau Mau and the Spanish Civil War in terms of their respective causes, eventual goals, and why they should not be clubbed together. And for a more detailed treatment of Mau Mau, Spanish Civil War, and a brief biography of Derek Walcott, you can check out our YouTube channel or the links given in the description below. I'm Professor Singh, and I thank you for watching. To know about our upcoming videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. And if you want to see a video of your choice, send us a request using the link below. Thank you once again, and have a great day.